Welcome to MMStv, made possible by the Filmmakers Project through the YMCA. I'm Carmen, and we're here today to give you a brief tour of the Marietta Middle School. We will also include in our tour a brief overview of the history of MMS, that when established was not a middle school at all. So let's turn it over to Kennley.
Thank you, and you were right about MMS not being a middle school.
What was it?
It was a high school built in 1926. The gym was then added in 1929. The high school was turned into MMS in 1967. Let's take a look at the gym now.
Let's move on to the cafeteria. Many students don't know that the cafeteria, where students eat lunch and take a break from classes, was in fact once a classroom. That's right, it was a word working. Now we are going to head down to the hall, to the main office, where all the magic and hard work happens to make this school run efficiently.
We are now going to head upstairs to where the students of MMS do all of their research, and the place where we did most of our research for this project, the library. Introduce you to a teacher who has made a big impact on MMS.
How has the school changed since you've taught here?
Well, first of all, there was a huge physical change in the school because when I came here, it was before they had the millions of dollars renovation. And so the cafeteria was up on the third floor, where now it's down in the basement underneath the gym. So we used to have a cafeteria upstairs. The hallways and the lockers were all, and the floor were all dark brown. So the whole building had kind of a dark feeling to it because of the colors in it. And so physically, they renovated the school and they made it a lot brighter and they moved the cafeteria and they made a mini gym and they created a lot more space for teachers. That's how the schools changed physically. Oh, and they added that glass corridor in there. That never used to be there. And up on the sixth grade floor, we didn't have lockers. They had to put their coats and their backpacks in the classroom. So everybody thought it was really cool when we got the renovation and everybody got lockers. I would say student-wise, we have a lot less students than when we first started. When I first came here, our sixth grade had about 340 kids in it. Now our sixth grade has about 240 kids. So over the years, the size of the classes, well, I wouldn't say the size of the classes got smaller, we just have less teachers. As we got less kids, we had less teachers. How else is school? We've been through several principals when we were there, since I've been here, and assistant principals. We've lost some home ec and some French and some Spanish classes that we used to have here. So we have a few less offerings for classes. But what I've also seen changed more is that we have a lot more, it's a lot more active than it used to be. We have a lot more science supplies, so we do science experiments all the time. We've got microscopes, and we've got rock samples, we've just got lots and lots of materials. And the kids do lots of group projects and work together. And when I first started, it didn't seem like we did as much of that. So physically, the building is a lot bigger, a lot more room in it, and a lot lighter. And kid-wise, it's a lot more active.
Okay. How has the form of discipline changed since you have been at MMS?
That's really hard to say because I've changed with the kids, so the way I do things has kind of changed along with the kids. We now have a handbook, and we didn't have such an elaborate handbook when we first got started. So it seems like there's probably a lot more rules because when I started teaching, there were no cell phones, and there were no iPods, and there were no cameras and different things that we have to take care of with some procedures and rules. Discipline-wise, I don't know. Kids are kids. They've always been the same. They've always been good, and they've always been ornery. We've always had to take care.
How long have you been teaching at MMS?
Well, I've been here at Marietta Middle School since 1987. That's the year the sixth grade came up here. Before that, they were in the elementary schools. And so when they moved the ninth grade to the high school, they were going to move the sixth grade up here. and they took volunteers. And so I had taught fifth grade for several years, and I said, I'm ready for something new, so I came up here in 1987.
What subjects have you taught?
Here it's been just language arts and science, and I've taught the accelerated classes probably most of the years, as well as regular classes.
What is the funniest haircut you've ever seen come through the school?
Oh, it's a classic. It's the kid that shaved his head on both sides and left a mohawk in the middle, probably about this long, and then put the gel and spiked it so it kind of looks like the crown of the Statue of Liberty, sideways.
What has kept you here all these years?
I can tell you in one word, kids. I feel like I never get any older, because every year I have 11 and 12 year olds in my class, so I never get any older. And it's the kids.
Has a student ever taught you anything?
Lots of things. And I was thinking about that question, and I believe probably the answer is, taught me not to be too proud to apologize. Because even adults make mistakes, and sometimes you find out later that, oops, maybe I should have listened to that child, or maybe I should have done that, or I should have promised to do something and then forgot to do it. So they taught me never to be too proud to apologize.
What was the most rewarding moment you have ever had as a teacher?
Oh, I've had so many. I probably can't even begin to pick one, but I can give you a couple recent examples, which are sort of like examples of the things that have happened over the years that make you really decide you love teaching. We did this activity in science called the Naked Egg Drop, where you have to build a landing device, and we build it out of paper, straws, tape, and 1 square foot of bubble wrap. And the object was to drop the egg from the highest point, catch it, and not let it break. And there were 2 boys in one of my classes who learning comes hard to them, and they don't always do very well on tests. They were so excited about this, and they talked to each other about it. They would stop me in the hall, and they said, we've got a really good idea. I think it's going to win. And when it was all said and done, they did win. They dropped an egg from the 3rd floor to the 2nd floor, and it didn't break. And that, and the look in those boys' eyes, and the gratification and the excitement that they were the best at something when they usually weren't, is a reward in itself.
What is the weirdest thing you have ever experienced while at school?
Oh, well, it's been funny things and sad things and lots of weird things, but I can't think of one in particular except I'll tell you one from 1987, the first year. You know, there's certain years you remember. When I was teaching at Phillips, I lost my watch. And I was kind of upset because my husband had just given it to me, and I offered the kids a $5 reward if they could find it. Nobody could find my watch. School, it was at the end of school, and on the last day came a little box, and in it was a watch. And the kids had bought me one because I had lost it. And it was very touching. Well, here's the weird part. I found it at home in a bowl. I don't know how it got there. It's probably cooking. It's actually this watch, and I found it in a bowl, and it was really weird because then I couldn't wear it for 3 years to school. I had to wear that watch they gave me, and on the first day of school, they kept asking me, do you have the watch we bought you, Mrs. Stiles? So I wore that watch for 3 years. It was just really weird to lose it, to find it, and then realize to not wear it for 3 years was kind of a weird thing, but a good thing at the same time.
Is there anything else you would like to tell us about MMS?
It's a great place to teach.
Well, that concludes our brief tour and the overview of the history of the Marietta Middle School. We hope that you've learned something about our school that you didn't already know. Thank you for joining us for MMStv. I'm Kayla Freudenberger. Have a great rest of the school year.
Young man, there's no need to feel down. I said, young man, pick yourself off the ground. I said, young man, 'cause you're in. place you can go. I said, young man, when you're short on your dough, you can stay there. And I'm sure you will find many ways to